Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Shiladitya Rakshit, the World Health Organization. This is module 29. It is known as the World Health Organization, is a United Nations specialized agency and is responsible for coordinating health related activities within the UN system. What is the objective of the World Health Organization? Basically, it talks about human survival and healthy livelihoods are the ultimate goals and the true measures of success of humanitarian assistance. Within humanitarian assistance, the specific objectives of the health interventions are: A, reduce the risk of excess to avoid mortality, morbidity and disability that could result from the disaster crisis, and to restore the delivery of and access to preventive measures and curative health care. Apart from this, this is important because it must show that health care must be given as quickly and as possibly in a very sustainable manner. What is the role of WHO or the World Health Organization? The role of WHO in a humanitarian emergency is to basically provide technical advice and guidance, and most essentially, where needed, material support to national health authorities as well as other entities when present. Not only that, it provides health cares to other partners in assessing situation and needs and in planning, implementing and most important evaluating measures to provide medical care to ordinary people afflicted with conflicts and protect the health and safety of the affected population. This is one aspect and one function of the World Health Organization. Apart from that, it does certain building capacities, like rebuilding the health system and capacities and provide leadership to the international community in relation to health and facilities coordination of international bodies throughout the world. The primary objectives which the student will learn and the learning outcomes will be that the role of the World Health Organization, how it carries out its functions, and most importantly, whether it has been able to sustain the goals of human rights. The WHO works to improve global health care on behalf of 194 member states. The primary task includes setting standards care for the international community. It aims also improving the capacity of developing world health care providers via both direct funding and facilitating partnerships with third parties, as well as monitoring and publishing statistics which shows the various global health trends, such as HIV for example, or other afflicted diseases across the world. What are its core functions? As set out in the WHO's 12th General Program of Work for the period 2014 to 2019, the organization's core functions are and includes: number one, providing leadership on matters critical to health, and not only that, but engaging in partnerships where joint action is needed. Secondly, shaping the research agenda and stimulating the generation, translation and dissemination of information, as well as valuable knowledge which culminates from field experience. Three, it also sets norms and standards and promoting and monitoring the implementation. Articulating ethical and evidence-based policy options. So, these are generally the important aspects. Apart from dissemination information, etcetera, the World Health Organization or WHO provides technical support, catalyzing change and building sustainable institutional capacity and monitoring the health situation and assessing that the health trends which prevail across the world. Then there are certain leadership priorities. In addition to these six core functions which I have mentioned before, the World Health Organization adopted six leadership priorities basically to give focus and direction to its public health agenda. These are universal health coverage, which is most important, and caters to countries afflicted by conflicts, etcetera. The internal health regulations of 2005. Three, increasing access to medical products. Fourth, social, economic and environmental detriments. Five, non-communicable diseases. And six, health related millennium development goals. Let us go in the history of health, World Health Organization. Health has long been a concern of the international community and was one of the themes taken up by the early international organizations of the pre-Second World War era. For example, 1902 saw the establishment of a Pan-American Sanitary Organization in Washington, D.C. that was concerned primarily with quarantines, general hygiene, education, and the spread of infectious diseases. An office, International de Hygiene Publique, was established in Paris in 1907 to deal with quarantine and sanitation, because you must remember that malaria was such a huge problem at that time. Apart from that, there were certain other conventions relating to food hygiene, biological standardization and hospital construction. And in 1921, the most was a watermark. The League of Nations established the World Health established a health organization in accordance with Article 23 of the Covenant of the League of Nations. Now, once this organization was established, members of the League agreed to endeavor to take steps in matters of international concern for the prevention and control of disease. After the onset of World War II, however, the Office International de Hygiene Publique, which is a French word, closed. And the League of Nations Health Organization was reduced to a fraction of its former scope, relegating action on international fronts to war-related organizations such as the United Nations, Relief and Rehabilitation, which carried out various administrative works. At the time of the founding of the United Nations in 1945, it was to be kept in mind that there was a significant need for a new organization that could address global health issues in the post-World War II era. For example, Article 55 of the newly written UN Charter committed the United Nations to promote solutions of international economic, social and health related problems. In keeping with this mandate of the UN, the Economic and Social Council began meeting first in 1946. The purpose of the meeting was to outline a proposal for the foundation of a World Health Organization under the UN umbrella. The constitution of the World Health Organization was eventually presented, and it was necessary for adoption at the International Health Conference held in New York, USA, from 19th June to 26 July 1946. It was basically signed by representatives of 61 states and entered into force on 7th April 1948. This date, students will come to note, is celebrated annually across the world as the World Health Day. Having said that, the institution of the WHO, the health organization, is headquartered in Geneva, Switzerland. However, the operations are spread worldwide. The other office is in Malaysia, 6 regional offices and 150 individual country offices, making it one of the most decentralized of the UN agency. The WHO employs more than 7,000 public health experts, including medical doctors, public health specialists, scientists, epidemiologists, administrators, finance information system professionals. Apart from those not directly related to healthcare, it also employs people who have gained expertise in economics, health statistics and emergency relief. Now, the WHO is composed of 3 primary organs. One is the World Health Assembly, 2 is the Executive Board, 3rd is the Secretariat, and then there is the World Health Assembly, which is its primary decision making body, and it always consists of delegations more or less of all 194 member states. They meet annually in Geneva to determine the policies of the World Health Organization. The executive board of the World Health Organization is made of 34 health experts elected for 3 terms. The board acts as the executive agency for the World Health Assembly, implementing decisions and policies, providing advice and taking any other facilitative tasks. The secretariat of the WHO is the largest of the 3 primary organs, employing over 8,000 staff. It is led by a director general who is appointed by the World Health Assembly for a tenure of 5-year renewable term. The current director general is Dr. Margaret Chan. She was appointed on 9 November 2006 and, interesting to note, was appointed for a second term that will continue through June 30th, 2017. Now, what is the role of WHO as a forum for human rights? The human right to health is contained in a number of international and regional human rights treaties. Article 12 of the International Covenant of Economic, Social and Cultural Rights, ICSCR, for example, attests that the state parties to the present covenant recognize the rights of everyone to the enjoyment of the highest attainable standards of physical and mental well-being. Apart from this, there are certain steps. The steps to be taken by the state parties to the present covenant to achieve the full realization of this right, inter alia, includes those necessary for the provision for the reduction of stillbirth as well as the rate of infant mortality across the world. Its primary aim is the development of the healthy child. Second, the improvement of all aspects of environment as well as industrial hygiene, because people do work in terrible factory conditions across the world, it caters to their rights as well. It also looks into the prevention, treatment and control of epidemic, endemic, occupation and other diseases. The creation of conditions which could assure to all medical service and medical attention in the event of sickness. So, basically it aims to give an environment which is conducive not only to healthy birth, but also to a healthy standard of living. Additional protections included in many international and regional instruments. An example of this is the Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, the Convention on the Rights of the Child, CRC, the European Social Charter, the African Charter on Humans and Peoples, rights as well as protocol of the San Salvador to the American Convention on the Human Rights in the area of economic, social and cultural rights, to name a few. It is because of the status as a UN specialized agency and its focus on the attainment by all peoples of the highest possible level of health, the WHO is a natural forum for human rights work. Now, what is this human rights work relating to? It only focuses with other concomitant rights with respect to right to health. The WHO's work to improve health systems around the world contributes directly to the fulfillment of every person's right to health. However, the WHO's position with respect to human rights discourse has shifted over the last 7 decades and has slowly moved towards policies keeping tandem with changing international and political tides. In its early years, the WHO Secretariat was very active in helping define the human rights agenda for public health. At that time, the DG of WHO, Brock Chisholm, put in 1951, the whole program approved by the World Health Assembly. And he said, not an exact quote, but it represents a concentrated effort on the part of member states to ensure the right to health. So, the right to health has primarily been the main focus of the World Health Organization ever since. In keeping with this philosophy, the early World Health Organization was active in pushing a broad understanding of the right to health in human rights expanse instruments in line with the positive definition in its own constitutions. But the World Health Organization has not always functioned very smoothly. Beginning in the 1950s, however, Cold War politics led to a shift in the WHO strategy. It slowly started to move away from human rights discourse, preferring to position itself as a technical organization rather than a political one. As Director General Marcolini Gomes Cando stated in 1957, the WHO was not an organization which was entrusted with safeguarding legal rights. The altered focus allowed the WHO to maintain political neutrality during the heights of Cold Wars, that is the 50s and 60s. But it also meant at the same time that the organization gave up its leadership position with respect to defining the scope of the right to health within international human rights and discourse. So this was during the Cold War. As the Cold War came to a close, the WHO returned to using human rights language. And when UN Secretary General Kofi Annan in 1997, for example, called for the UN specialized agencies to mainstream human rights in their activities, it is in response to that the WHO Director General Harem Brundtland was ready to do so. The organization continues the process of incorporating human rights more fully into its mandate as a part of the ongoing reform process launched at the 2012 World Health Assembly. The WHO has always committed for promoting the mainstreaming of gender, equity, and human rights throughout all levels of the organization. To that end, it has established Health and Human Rights Unit to serve as a focal point not only for human rights integration, but to give a safe environment within the WHO's mandate. In today's time and date, the WHO's human rights activities are far reaching. It engages in awareness raising and capacity building activities such as workshops and training seminars, and producing popular and technical pamphlets and videos with respect to the right to health at both regional and national levels. Secondly, it submits statements and reports to UN bodies charged with monitoring and evaluating human rights issues. It includes human rights concerns. Thirdly, in its policy recommendations. These recommendations are given to national government, and more or less, it has generally attempted to adopt a rights-based approach to health, which aims to make human rights a framework for not only health development, but also at the same time, it examines the human rights implications of any of its health policy program relating to food and famine, for legislation, and make human rights an integral dimension of the design, implementation, monitoring, and evaluation of health related issues and other related programs, especially those of policies. In all its spheres, it includes political, economic, and social aspects of world health policies. In addition, WHO maintains a number of focus programs on issues of particular interests, whose quality rights protect, for example, is a very interesting project. It seeks to improve human rights in mental health and social care facilities, which is such a growing problem in the world. The organization works to broaden access to medicines, an essential component of right to health in conflict-affected areas, by promoting best practices, new funding models, and other mechanisms. It has worked with the UN Office of the High Commission for Human Rights to develop strategies, various kinds of strategies for protecting the right to health through and during poverty reduction. And most important, it has paid special attention to promoting gender equality in the provision and distribution of healthcare. Apart from this, of all its work which has done, the who is not an alien criticism. There is a criticism of the who's commitment to a rights-based approach. Andra Zidder, for example, of the British Institute of International Comparative Law, for example, argues that WHO's 2005 international regulations do not, under no circumstances, sufficiently integrate human rights. She argues, but instead only alludes to rights as something external to the regulations. The 2005 international health regulations were also under criticism, which were updated in response to the threat of infectious diseases such as SARS, H1N1 influenza, Ebola, MERS and polio virus are arguably the most important global health treaty of the 21st century. They do include a provisions guaranteeing that public health measures will be taken with full respect. It is essential to note that Dr. Zidder argues that regulations should contain more specific human rights rather than putting human rights in an ambiguous plane. Therefore, in order to summarize, it is essential to note that the World Health Organization was formed out of a mutual agreement of all parties to cater to world health as a human right. It has membership of various nations. It takes down policies. These policies are implemented across the globe. It makes various treaties. It looks into mental health, looks into matters of childbearing, etcetera, and further it looks into the prevention of diseases such as H1N1, SARS and the Ebola virus. Thank you.